So hello everyone, welcome back again. As we all are eagerly waiting for NABARD's notification, but there are still no signs from NABARD for the notification. We all have even started our preparation, and in our previous some videos we have discussed that how to prepare for NABARD exam as well as how to prepare for ARD ESI through free YouTube sources, right? Similarly, we have also discussed book list of NABARD Grade A 2023. As well as recently we also discussed 3 months rigorous plan and strategy to clear NABARD Grade A exam. One most important doubt which came after that video in the comment section, we found out ki bahut sare students ye puch rahe, sir, is it really possible to complete the syllabus if we study for 3 months for almost 6 to 8 hours? So therefore we are today going to discuss a very important topic which is related to time management, and that topic is 4 hour study sufficient for clearing NABARD exam? So here we are not considering a huge amount of time such as 16 ghante padhna, 13 ghante padhna, 14 ghante padhna. Okay, we are not doing that. Rather, we are keeping a basic minimum time, that is 4 hours. And is prioritization of 4 hours, is planning of 4 hours, as well as keeping 4 hours study, is it possible to clear NABARD exam or not? That we will discuss in this specific video. So without wasting time again, let's start our today's discussion. That is really 4 hours time sufficient to clear NABARD exam if we study for 4 hours daily. Okay, so first thing for the discussion is the major relation of aspirant and time management or time. So jab hum aspirant aur time ki baat karte, you may be an aspirant and you may be giving any exam. We all know that every aspirant, when he wakes up daily, he always promises to himself that aaj kuch bhi ho jaye, I will definitely prioritize my study hours. Aaj main 13 ghante padhunga, aaj main 14 ghante padhunga, kuch bhi ho jaye, aaj main 10 ghante to padh ke rahunga. But what happens at the end of the day? That specific aspirant is there, he always fails. Arre, aaj yaar 2 ghante bhi padh nahi paya. And why he fails? He fails because he always imagines to prioritize his study hours, but rather falls in the trap of all the other things. Now these other things may be his job. Kuch aspirants may be, jo bhi working aspirants hai, wo to kahenge ki yaar aaj to main 10 ghante padhna chahta tha, I wanted to study for 10 hours, but my job is only of 9 hours. So it won't be possible. I wanted to prioritize my study hours time, but it is not possible for me. Similarly, for non-working candidates, it may be other exams, it may be your relatives. Aapke ghar mein chacha aa gaye, aapke ghar mein koi mama aa gaye, theek hai? It may be similarly household chores, theek hai? Chahe kuch bhi ho, ghar ka kaam karna, okay? Kahin par jaake ration lana ho, ya phir kahin par koi dusra kaam karna ho. Similarly, sabse bada national jo hamari hobby hai, wo hai Instagram ki reels scroll karna. सिमिलरली नेटफ्लिक्स और प्राइम टाइम जो भी आपके वीडियोज है, कोई नई वेब सीरीज आई वो देखना, राइट? एंड देन मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंटली आफ्टर डूइंग ऑल दिस अननेसेसरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स, ऑफकोर्स हम थक जाएंगे, सो वी विल स्लीप. सो वॉट हैपन्स इज दैट डेली एस्पिरेंट वेक्स अप एट 5 o'clock, ही ऑलवेज मेक्स अ गोल, मेक्स अ प्रॉमिस कि आज भाई इतने घंटे पढ़ेंगे, आई विल प्रायोरिटाइज माई स्टडी आवर्स, आई स्टडी फॉर 10 hours. एंड वॉट हैपन्स इन हिज story is that he ends up with doing the unnecessary things which are actually the hindrances in his preparation, and then he ends up to not even study for 2 to 3 hours. Okay, so this is what happens in aspirant's life. So today we are going to discuss how to prevent what happens to our NABARD aspirant if he has thought about to prioritize 4 hours daily. How can he do that, and how can he complete the NABARD's syllabus? So first let us try to understand. We all know, if you consider phase 1 and phase 2, we are having 8 subjects, right? So ye 8 subjects ko you have to understand for clearing NABARD exam. NABARD is a very easy to moderate level exam. It is not that difficult exam. This you will only understand if you understand the importance of time management in NABARD preparation. Why? Because as 8 subjects are there at the first stage of the exam only. If you compare NABARD exam with other any of the exam, it may be RBI, SEBI or other banking exams, NABARD has 8, which is a very huge number. 8 subjects, this increases the width of the syllabus. Therefore, equal time slot should be given to each subject, and that also based on importance. For example, as we all know, the core of NABARD's syllabus or exam is agriculture and rural development in ESI, and these both subjects should get major time in preparation. So now when we understand this, that the time allocation, the time management, equilateral time distribution per subject is very, very important. And here we are considering total time of 4 hours. So you can see here, in total, we are having 8 subjects with us. This 8 subjects, we have decided daily. I'm going to wake up and I have total study hours of 4. Okay, so I'm having 4 hours. Now you may be a working candidate. You may be a candidate who is full-fledgedly only giving NABARD exam, or maybe you are an candidate who is giving other exams also, like banking exam, maybe civil services exam, maybe other regulatory bodies exam like RBI, SEBI, and along with those exams, you are also giving NABARD exam. So you may fall into any of the category, but we are discussing you are having 4 hours minimum time on daily basis. Okay, so how we are going to prioritize this? Simple. Subject has been given and time allocation per subject has been given. So look at here very, very carefully what we are doing. Current affairs, that is general awareness, we are giving half hour. PIB and government schemes, this is important from the dynamic or current point of view also, as well as from economic and social issues point of view also. Therefore, we are giving it 1 hour. Quant and reasoning, as well as other subjects such as computer knowledge and decision making, we are again giving 1 hour. And the most important subjects such as ESI and ARD, we are giving total 1.5 hour. Okay, as we consider ESI, of course, macroeconomic as well as Indian economic point of view, it's very easy to understand. So we are giving half hour here. Whereas ARD is very core as well as a subject to which students are not introduced to. Therefore, this is the total categorization NABARD aspirant should have with himself. तो नाबार्ड एस्पिरेंट ने ये ध्यान रखना है कि अगर उसके पास 4 घंटे, इफ इज हैविंग 4 hours विद हिमसेल्फ, दिस इज हाउ ही शुड कैलिब्रेट हिज टाइम. ओके, नाउ दिस व्हाटएवर टाइम एलोकेशन वी हैव गिवन, दिस इज ड्यूरिंग हिज प्रिपरेशन फेज. प्रिपरेशन फेज इन द सेंस, सपोज इफ यू आर एमिंग फॉर नाबार्ड ग्रेड ए एग्जाम, मे बी फॉर 2023, सो व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू फिनिश द कंप्लीट सिलेबस, यू आर हैविंग 3 to 4 months फॉर प्रिपरेशन. सो इफ यू study, or if you allocate only 4 hours for 3 to 4 months, this is my guarantee that you can complete the syllabus also, and you will not just clear the NABARD exam, but rather you can even top the exam. Mark my words here, 4 hours are enough to even complete the syllabus along with practicing the mocks. Now this was the preparation phase. Now after preparation phase, there comes exam phase, that is last two months before the exam. When that comes, you have to understand that revision becomes very, very important. So same subjects are there, but here 1 hour should be given to current affairs and dynamic subjects such as PIB, government schemes revision, and half hour should be given for quant and reasoning practice. Okay, half hour should be given for quant and reasoning practice. ESI and ARD revision ke liye you have to give half hour, and mock test, solving as well as analysis, you should give 2 hours. This in total again gives you 4 hours, and this is nothing but exam phase preparation. So first is preparation phase, that is when you will complete the syllabus in 4 hours if you daily study. This is the categorization, I hope you got it. And then comes exam phase, when you are giving a dedicated 2 hours for even mock test and its analysis. So in this way, if you follow this, even for 2 to 3 months, you can complete your syllabus also, and you can even give almost 10 to 15 mock tests also with the analysis. Then we talk about daily planner. So here I have distributed, you can see here, for working aspirant, other exams aspirant, and full-time aspirant. So try to understand, this is daily planner for all these three candidates. Okay, so first let us consider you are a working aspirant. Working aspirant in the sense, you daily wake up and 9 hours of your day go for your job or go for your work. So simple, you are having morning 1 hour with you. I am not considering that ki aap 5 baje utho aur tabhi hi 4 ghante padho. No, do not take excessive stress, rather plan your time very, very properly. So morning, wake up 1 hour early, just 1 hour. Keep 1 hour for ESI and ARD preparation as well as for other subjects which are there. For example, कभी computer awareness लगा करने के लिए, कभी लगा कि decision making किया, तो वो आप यहाँ पर कर सकते हो. Evening 3 hours, when you come after your job, you can do current affairs, general awareness, PIB, government schemes, and practice of quant and reasoning. Okay, so here you can allocate 2 hours for current affairs, GA, PIB, government schemes, and quant and reasoning you can do 1 hour practice. Okay, so this is the time allocation per subject for working aspirant. Now here out, why we have not given again hour wise categorization, because for each working aspirant there definitely should be some flexibility. Okay, aapko yahan par flexibility di gayi hai. You can even categorize this morning 3 hours and evening 1 hour, or if you are a early morning bird, okay, and if you think no, I study at night, then you can definitely keep 1 hour in the morning and 3 hours in the evening. Is tarah se working aspirant prepare kar sakta hai. Now let's talk about other exams aspirant. Here I am talking about all the other exams, in the sense you may be a civil services aspirant, you may be other banking exams aspirant, you may be regulatory body exams aspirant, such as you are preparing for RBI or SEBI exam, plus you are preparing for NABARD. Okay, when you understand this, what is one specific truth about other exams aspirant, that definitely these students will be doing daily current affairs for their other exams also. Okay, so here out of total 8 to 10 hours of your preparation, for example, suppose मैं एक student हूँ, मैं other exams aspirant हूँ, मैं RBI का भी preparation कर रहा हूँ और मैं NABARD भी देने वाला हूँ. So let's consider I am having 10 hours for my preparation, 10 hours, then 6 hours I will give for RBI and 4 hours maybe on a minimum I am giving for NABARD. Then what I will do? Simple, I should give 3 hours to ESI ARD and 1 to 2 hours I should give to current affairs, GA, PIB, government schemes. Because quant and reasoning definitely you are going to do for RBI, because in RBI and NABARD also quant and reasoning, ESI, English, these are common subjects. So here where you have to do smart time as well as smart planning. Okay, so you cannot study quant and reasoning for RBI, that would be different, and quant and reasoning for NABARD, that would be different. This would be a total foolishness to do. Right, so this is how you can save your time. Similarly, you may be even studying or maybe preparing for other exam. Okay, you may be doing your higher studies, that also total whatever time is there, 8 to 10 hours, you can divide it 50-50%, and 4 hours minimum, 4 ghante to koi bhi de sakta hai, right? 4 hours minimum we can give it for NABARD, and here also you can give this distribution, you can do it again based on importance, where ESI and ARD is given maximum portion. Then comes full-time aspirant. When I talk about full-time aspirant, all those specially NABARD preparing aspirants, that I am an aspirant who is giving only NABARD exam, main NABARD grade A 2023 ko target kar raha hu, I am targeting NABARD grade A 2023 and I am giving no other exam. For all these students, aapka to aisa hal hai ki simran ja jee le apni zindagi. What it means? All of the time is yours. Aapko jo chahiye wo aap kar sakte ho. Rather, you should be not just thinking about clearing the exam, but rather being at the topper of the final list of NABARD, right? So here, students preparing only for NABARD exam, all time is yours. ESI, ARD, current, GA, PIB, government schemes you have to distribute, and you should at least, if you are a full-time NABARD aspirant, then you should allocate not just minimum 4 hours, but rather more than that. Okay, here we are talking about minimum 4 hours, and this is how you can distribute morning and evening, either 1:1:2 ratio or maybe 1:1 ratio. That means either morning you can keep 1 hour and evening 3 hours, or either morning 2 hours or evening 2 hours. So this is the daily planner for all these three aspirants. Now let's talk about a very important aspect, that how to manage the time. How to manage the time. So there are two aspirants here. One is a working aspirant. Working aspirant in the sense, jinka job hai, jo roz utkar job ke liye jate hai, with those candidates who are having 9 hours, which goes into their daily job, right? For all these working aspirant, there are some do's and there are some don'ts. Similarly, for non-working aspirant, in non-working aspirant, all those students who are preparing for other exams and all those aspirants who are preparing only for NABARD exam, those are here. Now try to understand very carefully. For working aspirant, every second and minute matters. हर एक second matter करता है, हर एक minute matter करता है. लेकिन याद रखना, I have seen many of the working students cribbing about that we don't get enough time. Full time students have 8 to 10 hours to prepare. So for all the working aspirants, keep your ears up now. Listen to me very carefully. It's not about how much time you get. It's rather about how you utilize your minimum time. So here, that is why I am today discussing with you. Only 4 hours if you give to yourself, you can clear NABARD exam. मैं बोल नहीं रहा हूँ आप 8 घंटे दो, 10 घंटे दो. No unrealistic targets. I am giving you a realistic target of just 4 hours per day. So how much time you are having, that doesn't matter. It's how you utilize it. 4 hours of study is very enough for clearing NABARD in 2 to 3 months. And even completing your syllabus, okay? And but you have to take care, all the working aspirants have to take care of zero time wasting. Zero time wasting means in the sense what? For example, whenever you are traveling in metro, whenever you are traveling in train or maybe by a public transport, tab bhi aapne earphones laga kar kuch na kuch aapke syllabus completion ka ya fir aapke current affairs ka, aapke PIB ya fir videos ho gaye Manish sir ke, wo bhi dekh sakte ho. In this way, you have to prioritize and utilize your even seconds and minutes. Similarly, no relaxation and no recreation time you are having. So if you think you are a working aspirant or aap Instagram ke reel scroll karoge, aaj ye web series dekhta hu, no, you are not having even 15 minutes or half an hour for your relaxation or recreation. Why? Because that time you have to dedicatedly put into NABARD's preparation. Then only you will get 4 hours. 4 hours which you can prepare dedicatedly for NABARD grade A exam. Now let's talk about non-working aspirant. When I talk about non-working aspirant, here they are having ample time with themselves, okay? But their planning and prioritizing subjects would be very, very crucial in their preparation. Similarly, exam oriented study should be there. For example, non-working aspirants ka sabse zyada bada problem kya hota hai? As they are having so much of time with themselves, they go on studying so much. वो PhD करना चालू कर देते. Okay? So having syllabus and doing just exam oriented study, because you have to, at the end you have to clear the exam, right? कुछ भी पढ़ना नहीं है. And then it's efficiency. So there is one term which is called as Parkinson's law. What is Parkinson's law? Parkinson's disease नहीं कह रहा हूँ, ठीक है? Dark joke था, ठीक है? Parkinson's law कह रहा हूँ. What is Parkinson's law? Simple. अगर आप अपनी जिंदगी में कोई भी काम कर रहे हो, if you are doing any work, and if you are not putting a deadline on that work will, the time required for the completion of that work will go on increasing. That means what? If you are having more time with you, Parkinson's law says that the efficiency will reduce in that context. So what it means? So today's discussion, what we are talking about, the 4 hours, whatever we have allocated, they are more efficient than the 10 hours or 14 hours of study a other candidate who would be doing. So for all the working aspirants as well as other aspirants who have only dedicated 4 hours, stop complaining as well as stop giving excuses. So we have given deadline of daily 4 hours, and Parkinson's law says that if we have given deadline, then definitely our efficiency would be maximum in that minimum stipulated time. Then comes an important aspect for non-working aspirant. Always remember, non-working aspirant is a full-time aspirant. Aap bas preparation kar rahe ho, either for other exams or for NABARD exam. So here, the most important thing is personality development. What personality development? So therefore, you should be thinking about your personality development. You get no time. If you prepare for 10 hours or maybe 8 hours for NABARD exam, aapka personality kaise develop hoga, right? So therefore, rather than giving yourself recreational time, rather keep a segregated time, keep some hours in your day for personality development as well as your skill upgrading. Okay, so as you all know, working aspirant goes for his job, goes for his work 9 hours a day. Jab wo kaam pe jate, automatically his whole day, his personality is being developed, maybe administration point of view, maybe in his domain, whatever he's working. Okay, so here for working aspirant, whenever he goes for the job, his personality development automatically takes place. But here for non-working aspirant, this doesn't take place. So therefore, a special time should be given for developing personality as well as skill upgradation. At last, we are talking about importance of time. कि वक्त जो है ना भाई साहब वो किसी के लिए भी नहीं रुकता है. सो आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इफ यू आर अ NABARD एस्पिरेंट देयर वुड बी थाउजेंड थिंग्स सच एज आपकी स्लीप आपके प्रिपरेशन के बीच में आएगी. द योर स्लीप विल कम एक्ट एज एन हिंड्रेंस. योर रिलेटिव्स विल बी आल्सो डिस्ट्रॉइंग योर टाइम. देन कम्स ऑफ कोर्स योर रिलेशनशिप्स. दीज विल ईट अप योर टाइम लाइक एनीथिंग एल्स. देन कम्स योर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वर्क दैट इज स्क्रोलिंग द रील्स, watching Amazon and Netflix web series, and then comes of course your job. All these are hindrances in your preparation, but I'll tell you what, if you study daily 4 hours, if you manage your time just for 4 hours, all these things will disappear and you will definitely be tomorrow in the NABARD's office. So make that true. Study for 4 hours minimum we have given. No unrealistic target has been given. And I wish you best of luck. I hope today you learned from this discussion, whatever disaggregation as well as whatever prioritization of the time as well as plan for 4 hours was given. I hope you instill it from tomorrow itself. And best of luck for your preparation. And just we will wait for the notification of NABARD Grade A 2023. Thank you.